गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक आवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस साइंस 8 स्टैंडर्ड स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर थर्ड चैप्टर सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑलरेडी वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट दैट व्हाट आर द फाइबर्स दैट इज नेचुरल फाइबर्स एंड सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल्सो एंड दैट नेचुरल फाइबर्स आर टू टाइप्स. वन इज एनिमल फाइबर्स एंड प्लांट फाइबर्स. So students, what is the synthetic fibers? Already I have told that fibers are two types. One is natural fibers which are we are getting from the nature, plants and animals. And second one is synthetic fibers. So what is the synthetic fibers? Now the fibers which are obtained or manufactured in industry by the human beings. Once again say, the fibers which are manufactured in industries by the human beings are called synthetic fibers. Also the synthetic fibers are also called as man-made fibers or artificial fibers. Okay students, so that means the fibers which we are making by the humans. Okay, so these are called as synthetic fibers. So examples are, what are they? Like rayon, nylon, polyester, spandex, acrylic. Okay, these are the examples of plastics. These are the examples of synthetic fibers. So let us start students. Write down first what is that synthetic fibers. I have written here. The fibers which are manufactured in industries by human beings are called synthetic fibers. Okay students, this is called as synthetic fibers. That means the fibers we are making by ourselves, by chemical, by industry. Okay, next. It is also called man-made fibers or artificial fibers. The synthetic fibers also called as man-made fibers, we can say. Also we can say artificial fibers. And what are the examples? Rayon, nylon, polyester, plastics, acrylic, spandex. These are the some important synthetic fibers which one we are used. Commonly we are using this synthetic fibers. Okay students? So how it is made up, how we are manufacturing the synthetic fibers. Before that, I will explain to you one with by examples, then you can understand how it is made up, how we are making the synthetic fibers in industry. Okay students, so do you have an idea about that wall, how the machines are making that wall of the house? Okay students, so you have seen that, you see here, I have drawn here one picture. This is one of the wall of the house. Okay, this wall how will make? It is made by cement, sand and bricks. Okay, but specially this is one house like that, I have one box like this there, this is called as bricks. So bricks together, one bricks together, it will joined by cement and sand like that, then it will form a one wall. Are you clear friends? So this bricks are the small unit of the wall. Yes, if it is a wall being large number, so it contains large number of bricks. So same like the other another one, you see, this is your string rope like, and here is the bricks. These are different number of bricks are jointed together and forming a string. Yes, same like these are the smaller units of that string, small unit of the wall. The one brick is a small unit of a one wall. Same like students, when we are synthetic fibers are made how? On small units, that is called as monomers or polymers. Okay, now see, the synthetic fibers where many monomer units combined to form a large unity called as a polymer. So how like one they are making? Same like one small unit, which one? Monomer. Mono means what? One. Small units of polymer. What is that? Small like blood cells, like suppose hemoglobin. Small cells are combined with that hemoglobin, one blood cell forming. Same like small units of the monomer. Monomers are combined to form a large unit. That is called as a, what is that friends? Polymer. You should see here how like that monomers are combined together and forming this linear monomer. So see, it is straight like, straight chain like. So this is linear monomer. This is cross-linked monomer friends. That means like here, this like it is there, this like it is there. So these are the cross monomer friends. Okay friends, so how this monomers is combining
together. That is process is called as a polymerization. How they are combining? That process. What is the process of that combinations? So see, the process of combining the monomer units into a large polymer is called a polymerization. I told you, when the bricks we are combining together and making a wall, same like the one unit small polymer, that unit of that a large unit of polymer, that one monomer combined with one process is there. That process, which process we are making one large polymer, that is called as a, the process is called as a polymerization. Okay students, so by that way we are making different types of synthetic fibers. Here one question arises, dear students, why we should make that synthetic fibers? Already we are getting that natural fibers from the plants and animals, then what is the necessity to make the synthetic fibers? Students, almost all you know that nowadays the populations are growing very rapidly, it is growing, so there is the process. So huge amount of number of process needs for it every day, so that is not easy to make by the animal fibers. So that's why we are depending, we are manufacturing that we develop that synthetic fibers, and it is, if you compare to that natural fibers and synthetic fibers, so many advantages are there. So by that way we are developing that synthetic fibers, and we are depending synthetic fibers. We will study what are the synthetic fibers and what is the rayon, what is the nylon, what is the polyester, plastics, acrylic, spandex in the next video. Okay students, one by one synthetic fibers we will discuss. So you should write down this all that, and you should draw this pictures on your notebook, and all that notes, definitions you should write in your classwork. Okay students, thank you all of you. Have a nice day.